give a very warm welcome and round of applause to Chef Michael Bonacini.
Well, let me tell you, this is a real treat, cooking along with the very, very talented Irene Matys. She is a wonderful, talented chef who is a huge advocate and supporter of local food. She is an incredible food stylist, recipe developer, blogger, and an incredible food photographer.
Michael, thank you so much for the most prestige welcome, and I am truly, truly honored to be sharing a stage with a renowned chef.
Are you ready to tag along with us? So we decided to create the Royal Schnitzel. So the Royal Schnitzel to me has this melted leek filling with a little cheese, a little mustard, a little lemon, and just to bring it alive.
I thought, what a great pairing with potatoes, right?
Absolutely.
It's a warm cypriot potato salad, and the potato salad features a tahini vinaigrette. It brings creaminess and nuttiness, and it's such a perfect vegan option for a creamy potato salad. And so we're all gonna start with the leeks first. So we're gonna melt a little bit of the butter, and we're gonna start sweating our meats.
What's important with those leeks, I believe, is that you need to have those leeks just begin to melt and soften. You know what, just enough softening so it allows the wonderful sweet juices of the leek to come out. There's the Dijon mustard, and we've got a little bit of the cheese now that we can add. And the cheese that we're adding today is a grand champion, two-year-old cheddar, and it is from Fromagerie Perron. When you win a ribbon at the Royal, that is an incredible achievement in the cheese world, in the dairy world, in the cattle world, in any of the over 300 to 400 classes that will be judged over the next 10 days here at the Royal. Once you've added the Dijon mustard, you've seasoned up the leeks, you've got the little of the cheese in, we remove the leeks so they allow them to cool down.
We're gonna start making our potato salad. So you have your potatoes here, and just gonna toss them into the water. They're already pre-cooked, so we just want to heat them up for a few minutes. What else is very special about it is the sun-dried black olives. So they do put a lot of the salt bite to the salad. Two key things for making perfect potatoes. And one being is salting your water, just like you would do in pasta, as well as putting your potatoes in when the water is cold. And the reason behind that is you want an even cook through your potatoes. So we want to dress our potato salad now that it's warm. You'll have some celery, you'll have some green onions, and some parsley. Toss all that in, and then we're going to whisk our dressing. You have some extra virgin olive oil. You have your tahini, your sesame pulp, your capers, lemon juice, Dijon mustard for extra creaminess and an extra bite. And we're gonna whisk it nice and creamy. Pour that creamy, flavorful dressing in your potato salad and toss it well. I'd like you to take 3 tablespoons of your cooking water and add it to your potato salad.
Good old potato water.
Reason why I like to use the cooking water, when it's seasoned, that warm water just makes it creamier and more flavorful.
You can't just get it from the tap. Well, the smell of those olives are absolutely spectacular. We go back to our chicken. We have our chicken breast that has been butchered, pounded, and ready to be stuffed with those delicious melted leeks.
You're gonna sprinkle a little bit of flour on top of your leeks and chicken.
It just helps to stick the meat to the meat.
Fold one side over to close it up.
We're going to prepare the lineup for breading our schnitzel. On one plate, we'll have our flour that has been seasoned with salt and pepper. Once we put our chicken breasts into the flour, we're going to shake off the excess, and then we're going to dip it into our egg wash. After the egg wash, you'll find a container of panko breadcrumbs ready for the final stage of pané. Add enough vegetable oil, 1/4 inch in the bottom.
Just a little tip to test your oil, to take a little bit of breadcrumbs and just put a little bit in your oil, and if it sizzles, you know that your oil is ready to be here.
Once the chicken is cooked, out onto the plate, fried egg on top, and then the final step is doing a little Bernoise with the excess butter. And just as it turns brown, it bubbles quite ferociously. We're going to add the kingers, fresh chopped parsley, a little anchovy, and a squeeze of lemon juice. Look at that. That is a dish of champions. And you are all champions today.
I just love the kind of people that come to the Royal Winter Fair. They're the best.
Yeah, it's quite the remarkable event, right? It's not just only the horses, but it's the producers, it's the farmers. It just highlights so much in our local, right? In our community, in our Ontario, in our Canada.
100%. If you have an inquisitive mind about anything to do with food, equine, livestock, farming, the biggest pumpkin, the tallest cornstalk, this is the place to be.
Absolutely.